Hello everyone, I am Dr. Parag. I am a pediatric cardiologist working in Mumbai. I take this opportunity to discuss variety of complex fetal echoes. This includes hypoplastic left heart syndrome, hypoplastic right heart syndrome, double inlet ventricles, as well as some other complex echo anomalies like heterology of Fallot, transposition of great arteries, CCTJ. I will also try to discuss with you very rare anomalies like conjoint veins and associated cardiac anomalies, topsy-turvy heart, or aortopulmonary window. Now let's start with how to assess a fetal echo of hypoplastic left heart syndrome. What are the common features and how to come to a diagnosis? Hypoplastic left heart syndrome is one of the common complex heart anomaly seen at an incidence of 1.6 to 3.6 per 10,000 live birth, and it is commoner in males. And risk of recurrence if anybody is affected in family is 0.5 to 2%. This is a specimen taken from Anderson. Just have a look to understand the basic pathology. That the left ventricle is very thick, it is very short lumen cavity, you can say, and it is not reaching up to apex as compared to this RV cavity is reaching up to apex. Ascending aorta is very small as compared to the pulmonary artery. So important feature of this is small left side and inability of left side to pump blood adequate to needs of body, and this anomaly is universally fatal in early neonatal period unless it is treated immediately. So important anatomical feature that we will talk about is mitral hypoplasia or atresia, smaller absent left ventricle with endocardial fibroelastosis, severe aortic stenosis or atresia, small aortic arch with coarctation, floor reversal in distal arch and oval foramen. Arch interruption is also known with hypoplastic left heart syndrome. This is another specimen. You can appreciate nearly atretic mitral wall with slit-like left ventricular cavity and a very big right ventricular cavity. This is small left atrium. Important hemodynamic feature of hypoplastic left heart syndrome are inability of left ventricle to pump blood to the requirements of the body. So there is a flow reversal observed in distal aortic arch. Also left ventricle is also not able to receive blood through mitral wall, so LA pressure increases and there is a flow reversal in oval foramen. Normal oval foramen flow is from right atrium to left atrium. In hypoplastic left heart it is from left atrium to right atrium. This disease may develop and progress over with gestational age. So a normal looking heart may develop into HLHS over a period of time. So if there is any flow acceleration across aortic wall or if left heart looks little smaller than usual, they need very close follow up for development of hypoplastic left heart syndrome. Now coming to the four chamber view of heart, we will see a non-apex forming or absent left ventricle. Left ventricle may be hypocontractile or non-contractile, endocardial fibroelastosis, absent or small mitral wall. Also look for tricuspid regurgitation, it's an ominous sign. If present, then chances of survival are not so good. And right ventricle will be dominant and with good contractility. This is a specimen that shows a small left ventricle with a small mitral wall. This is a big right ventricle. There is a fibroelastosis of left ventricle. This specimen is from Anderson. Now coming to the four chamber view, kindly note that a non-contractile left ventricle which is not going up to apex and a good contractile right ventricle. There is this whiteness curves means that there is a fibroelastosis of endocardium. This is another echo view that shows the right ventricle. The right ventricle is up to apex and left ventricle is not up to apex. LV is very small as compared to right ventricle. This is another fetal echo image that showing endocardial fibroelastosis. This whiteness is endocardial fibroelastosis and LV is not contracting, not going up to apex, and RV is going up to the apex. This is the cardiac apex. Another four chamber view. In this view, we can appreciate very small mitral wall, a little dilated left atrium, a small left ventricle, a big right ventricle, giving rise to dominant pulmonary artery. This is a short axis view. We can appreciate that left ventricle is not at all contractile, while right ventricle is contracting well. This is a color Doppler across mitral wall that shows significant mitral regurgitation. There is some problem with the mitral wall, maybe hypoplastic mitral wall. And this is a flow acceleration across aortic wall. Any flow acceleration across aortic wall is suggestive of aortic stenosis. So in this case, aortic stenosis was the main dominant feature that led to hypoplastic left heart. This is gradient across aortic wall. A 27 gradient at gestational age of 20-25 is very high, and it should be considered as a severe aortic stenosis, and it will definitely turn into a hypoplastic left heart. This is the same patient. Another important feature we'll talk about is flow reversal in aortic arch. Aortic arch may be very small and it may not be appreciated on 2D grayscale. A color Doppler assessment can show flow reversal in aortic arch. Though it's a unique feature of hypoplastic left heart, it is not diagnostic. You can occasionally get flow reversal in some other conditions or even in cases of normal heart or coarctation. It is generally seen in normal heart, it is generally seen in late third trimester, while in hypoplastic left heart, it is seen from second trimester onwards. So in this case, the dominant blue flow that we see is from the pulmonary artery, and the small red flow, that is a flow reversal in aortic arch. This is again the dominant red flow that is seen is in pulmonary artery, and the blue is a flow reversal in aortic arch. So this is pulmonary artery forward flow and the flow reversal in distal aortic arch. Again, this is a dominant pulmonary artery and this is a flow reversal in distal aortic arch. Incidentally, patient has got bilateral SVC, this one and this. These two are the bilateral SVC. So flow reversal in oval foramen, this suggests inability of left ventricle to receive blood, and there is increasing LA pressure with left to right flow in oval foramen, and IS may be bulging into right atrium. Normally IS is bulging into left atrium. So in this case, there is a flow reversal from left atrium into right atrium with interatrial septum bulging into RA. This is inferior vena, superior vena cava, this is inferior vena cava. Caudoquenal sweep is an important thing that we should do in every patient, every fetal echo, and reassess the sweep at very slow rate to understand the anatomy. I'll just show you a couple of patients. So in this case, we can appreciate that from fundic bubble going in, showing the small left ventricle with endocardial fibroelastosis, and finally showing the main pulmonary artery. There is the aortic arch cannot be appreciated well. This is another caudocranial sweep showing fundic bubble and dominant right ventricle and small left ventricle. Again, in this sweep, we cannot appreciate the aortic arch. We could appreciate aortic arch only on the color Doppler. So important thing we should understand is hypoplastic left heart is a progressive disease. Left heart or left side of the heart is very small as compared to right. It is important diagnostic feature, but also rule out other things that can mimic disease like coarctation, advanced gestational age, or TAPVC. Flow reversal in aortic arch and foramen ovale is important diagnostic features. Hope you have found this useful in your day-to-day practice. Thank you very much.